जय गोपी जना वल्लभा गिरिवर धारी। जय यशोदानंदन व्रज जन रंजन, यमुना तीरावनचारी, जय राधा माधव कुंज बिहारी। हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम हरे राम 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 हरे हरे। हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे। हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे। हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे। जय राधा श्याम सुंदर राधा श्याम सुंदर श्री राधे, जय कृष्ण बलराम जय कृष्ण बलराम कृष्ण बलराम जय वृंदावन धाम। जय गौरनिताय 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 श्री श्री गौरनिताय। जय जय प्रभुपाद 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 जय श्रील प्रभुपाद। नितय गौर हरि बोल हरि बोल नितय गौर हरि बोल। जय ओम विष्णुपाद परमहंस परिव्राजकाचार्य अष्टोत्तरत्सधि डिवाइन ग्रेस श्री अभय चरणारविंद भक्ति वेदांत महाराज स्वामी शिला प्रभुपाद की। जय ओम विष्णुपाद परमहंस परिव्राजकाचार्य अष्टोत्तरत्सधि डिवाइन ग्रेस शिला भक्ति सिद्धांत सरस्वती गोस्वामी महाराज शिला प्रभुपाद की। अनंत कोटि वैष्णववृंद की, नामाचार्य शिला हरदास ठाकुर की, प्रेम से कहो श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर श्रीवासादि गौर भक्तवृंद की श्री श्री राधा कृष्ण गोप गोपीनाथ श्याम कुंड राधा कुंड गिरि गोवर्धन की ब्रजभूमि श्री वृंदावन धाम की नवद्वीप श्री मायापुर धाम की पुरुषोत्तम क्षेत्र श्री जगन्नाथपुरी धाम की गंगा माई जमुना माई की सामवेद गौर भक्तवृंद की निताय गौर प्रेमानंदे ऑल ग्लोरीज टू द असेंबल्ड डिवोटीज ऑल ग्लोरीज टू द असेंबल्ड डिवोटीज ऑल ग्लोरीज टू द असेंबल्ड डिवोटीज ऑल ग्लोरीज ऑल ग्लोरीज ऑल ग्लोरीज टू श्री गुरु एंड श्री गौरांग गौर हरि बोल ओम नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय ओम नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय ओम नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय हरे कृष्णा टुडे वी आर रीडिंग फ्रॉम 10th कैंटो दिस इज चैप्टर 61 लॉर्ड बलराम स्लेस रुक्मी सो वी हैव श्लोक 22 टू 25 टू कवर टुडे सो वील रिसाइड 25th एंड रीड द परपोर्ट टेक्स्ट 25 दौहित्रायानुरुद्धाय पौत्रीं रुक्म्या ददाधरे रोचनां बद्धवैरोपी स्वसुः प्रियचिकीर्षया जानन्न धर्मं तद्यौनम् स्नेहपाशानुबन्धनः दौहित्रायानिरुद्धाय पौत्रीं रुक्म्या ददाधरेः रोचनां बद्धवैरोपी स्वसुः प्रियचिकीर्षया जानन्न धर्मं तद्यौनम् स्नेहपाशानुबन्धनः दौहित्रायानिरुद्धाय पौत्रीं रुक्म्या ददाधरे रोचनां बद्धवैरोपी स्वसुः प्रियचिकीर्षया जानन्न धर्मं तद्यौनम् स्नेहपाशानुबन्धनः ससुः प्रियचिकीर्षया जानन्न धर्मं तद्यौनम् स्नेहपाशानुबन्धनः दौहित्रायानिरुद्धाय पौत्रीं रुक्म्या ददाधरे रोचनां बद्धवैरोपी स्वसुः प्रियचिकीर्षया जानन्न धर्मं तद्यौनम् स्नेहपाशानुबन्धनः माताजी दौहित्रायानिरुद्धाय पौत्रीं रुक्म्या ददाधरे रोचनां बद्धवैरोपी स्वसुः प्रियचिकीर्षया जानन्न धर्मं तद्यौनम् स्नेहपाशानुबन्धनः वर्ड टू वर्ड मीनिंग दौहित्राय टू हिज डॉटर्स सन अनिरुद्धाय अनिरुद्ध पौत्रीम हिज ग्रैंड डॉटर रुक्मी रुक्मी आददात गेव हरे टुवर्ड्स लॉर्ड कृष्णा रोचनाम नेम्ड रोचना बद्ध बाउंड वैरह इन एनिमिटी अपि ऑल्दो स्वसुः हिज सिस्टर प्रियचिकीर्षया वांटिंग टू प्लीज जानन नोइंग अधर्मम इन रिलीजन तत् दैट यौनम मैरिज स्नेह ऑफ अफेक्शन पाश बाय द रोप्स अनुबंधन हुज बॉन्डेज ट्रांसलेशन एंड परपोर्ट ट्रांसलेशन रुक्मी गेव हिज ग्रैंड डॉटर रोचना टू हिज डॉटर सन अनिरुद्ध डिस्पाइट रुक्मी'स रिलेंटलेस फ्यूड विद लॉर्ड हरी although Rukmi considered this marriage irreligious he wanted to please his sister bound as he was by the ropes of affection purport Srila Sridhar Swami explains that according to the worldly standards one should not give one's beloved granddaughter to the grandson of one's bitter enemy thus we find the following injunction dvishadannam na bhoktavyam dushantam naiva bhojayet One should not eat an enemy's food or feed an enemy. There is also the following prohibition. Asvargyam lokavidvishtam dharma api acharet natu. One should not execute religious injunctions if they will obstruct one's journey to heaven or if they are odious to human society. It should be pointed out here that Lord Krishna is not really the enemy of anyone, as the Lord states in the Bhagavad Gita, Svardham sarvabhutanam gyatva mam shantim richati. One attains peace by understanding that I am the well-wishing friend of every living entity. Although Lord Krishna is everyone's friend, Rukmi could not appreciate this fact. And considered Lord Krishna his enemy. Still out of affection for his sister, he gave his granddaughter to Aniruddha. Finally, we should note that, contrary to the prohibition quoted above, one may not give up the basic principles of spiritual life merely because such principles are unpopular with people in general. As Lord Krishna states in the Gita 1866, Sarva Dharman Parityaja Mam Ekam Sharanam Vraja. The last word in spiritual duties is to surrender to the Supreme Lord, and that duty takes precedence over all secondary injunctions. Moreover, in this age, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu has kindly presented a sublime process that will attract all sincere people to come to the point of surrendering to the Lord. By following Lord Chaitanya's blissful process of chanting, dancing, feasting, and discussing spiritual philosophy, anyone can easily go back home, back to Godhead, for an eternal life of bliss and knowledge. Still, someone may argue that the members of the Krishna consciousness movement should not practice in the Western countries those ceremonies or activities that displease the people in general. We respond that even in the Western countries, when people are properly informed of the activities of the Krishna consciousness movement, they generally appreciate this great spiritual institution. Those who are especially envious of God will not appreciate any type of religious movement, and since such persons are themselves little better than animals, they cannot impede the great Krishna consciousness movement, just as the envious Rukmi could not impede the performance of Lord Krishna's pure pastime. Srila Prabhupada ki jai. गुरवे गौरचंद्राय राधिकाय तदालय कृष्णाय कृष्ण भक्ताय तद्भक्ताय नमो नमः हे श्री सनातन प्रभो करुणाम्बराशे हे रूप दुर्गत जनैक दयावलोक हे भट्ट युग्म सुमते रघुनाथ दास श्री जीव मे कुरुत मंद मते दयांतरात् यत्कीर्तनं यत्स्मरणं यदीक्षणं यदवंदनं यच्छ्रवणं यदर्हणं लोकस्य सद्यो विधुनोति कल्मषं तस्मै सुभद्राश्रवसे नमो नमः। नमाओं विष्णुपादाय कृष्णप्रेष्ठाय भूतले श्रीमते भक्तिवेदांत स्वामी इति नामिने। नमस्ते सारस्वते देवे गौरवाणी प्रचारिणे निर्विशेष शून्यवादी पाश्चात्य देशतारिणे। जय श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंदा श्री अद्वैत गदाधारा श्रीवासादि गौर भक्त वृंदा। हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे। यो अंत प्रविश्य मम वाच मिमां प्रसुप्तां संजीवयत्यखिल शक्तिधर स्वधाम्ना। अन्यांश हस्तचरण श्रवणत्वगादीन् प्राणान् नमो भगवते पुरुषाय तुभ्यं। हृदय से प्रेरणया प्रवर्तितो हम वराक रूपोपि तस्य हरे पदकमलं वंदे श्री चैतन्य देवस्य। हरे कृष्णा। सो इन दिस चैप्टर मोस्टली द प्रोजनी ऑफ कृष्णा हैज बीन डिस्कस्ड। सो कृष्णा हैड ओनली 16,108 वाइफ्स and from each of the wife he had 10 sons and one daughter, and these sons and daughter they also have their children. So you can imagine the size of the family of Krishna, it was so big. And all of the sons and the daughters which Krishna had, they were not produced by some like seminal discharge. This is Bhagavati Srishti, it was created by Krishna. Bhagavatam mentions Atmani Avaruddha Saurata, that Krishna never discharged any semen to produce these children. He is not like an ordinary man who had to produce children, then he had to take to such activities, but it was out of the sweet will of Krishna. It was the internal potency of Krishna. It was Bhagavati Srishti, Krishna's creation. And we never find that there was some problem with some baby or what. All of them were perfectly fine. They were perfectly intelligent. They were valiant, they were beautiful, and all of them were created by Krishna. In fact, most of the sons of Krishna, they were Vishnu Vansh only. Like we hear about Pradyumna. So he is the Vishnu Vansh, he is not any ordinary living entity. So Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, when explaining to Sanatana Goswami about the different expansions of Krishna, so he mentions about the view of that. So he mentions that first there is Krishna, the original Supreme Personality of Godhead. Krishna expands himself into Balaram. From Balaram comes the first Chaturvyuh, Vasudev, Sankarshan, Pradyumna and Aniruddha. From this first Chaturvyuh comes the Param Vyom Adhipati Narayan, who is the master of the Vaikuntha planets. From that Narayan comes the second Chaturvyuh, Vasudev, Sankarshan, Pradyumna and Aniruddha. So in the second Chaturvyuh, the Vasudev, he directly comes from Narayan. Directly he is an expansion of Narayan. And he is the presiding deity of the Brahman, Brahma Jyoti. Like Brahma Jyoti emanates from him only, Vasudev. He is the presiding deity of the consciousness, Chitta. From Vasudev comes the Sankarshan. Sankarshan is the presiding deity of Ahankar, false ego. And from him comes the Karunadakshaya, Vishnu. He is responsible for integrating and disintegrating this entire material cosmos. Like he is present as the gravitational force. As Krishna says in Bhagavad Gita, I keep the planets in their own place by my Shakti. So he is that gravity, and he is the person who is responsible for the dissolution of the entire universe. Then from Sankarshan comes Pradyumna. Pradyumna is the presiding deity of intelligence, Buddhi. And he is the source of Garbhodakshaya, Vishnu. He is responsible for the universal growth and maintenance. From Pradyumna comes Aniruddha. Aniruddha is the presiding deity of mind, man. And he is the source of Shirodakshaya, Vishnu. सो दिस वासुदेव संकर्षण प्रद्युम्न अनुरोध द सेकेंड चतुर्व्यूह इज ऑल्सो कमिंग एज द लीला व्यूह. सो इन द्वारका ऑल्सो वी सी वासुदेव संकर्षण प्रद्युम्न एंड अनिरुद्ध. वासुदेव इज कृष्णा द सन ऑफ वसुदेव. संकर्षण लॉर्ड बलराम इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड संकर्षण. सो ही इज कॉल्ड संकर्षण वाई बिकॉज ही वॉज अट्रैक्टेड फ्रॉम द वूम्ब ऑफ देवकी टू द वूम्ब ऑफ रोहिणी. सो इज कॉल्ड संकर्षण. देन प्रद्युम्न इज द सन ऑफ कृष्णा एंड अनिरुद्ध इज द सन ऑफ प्रद्युम्न द ग्रैंड सन ऑफ कृष्णा. सो दिस लीला व्यूह is in Dwarka and actually that is the original view, that is the source of all the other view. So when we know that when Krishna comes to this material world, he comes with all the other manifestations of Vishnu and all the other avatars also, like Vats, Kurma, Varaha, Nrsingh, they join with Krishna. Similarly, when the associates of Krishna comes, they are also joined with some of the other Vishnu ans. And in some case, they are joined by some demigods. The demigods also take birth to participate in the pastimes of Krishna. Like Brahmaji ordered, Bhavadbhi Ranshai Yadushup Janyatam. All of you take birth within the Yadu dynasty with your Ansha. So when the associates come, some of the demigods, they join with these eternal associates of the Lord. Like Yudhishthira Maharaj is an eternal associate of Krishna. But Yamaraj, the Ansh expansion of Yamaraj also takes birth along with Yudhishthira Maharaj. Similarly, Pradyumna, here we are discussing the marriage of Pradyumna and later Aniruddh. So Pradyumna is the Pradyumna is actually the eternal associate in Dwarka. He is the son of Krishna. But along with him comes the Pradyumna of that Chaturvyuh. And also along with him comes the Kamdev, the demigod, Cupid. So that he takes birth. So here Pradyumna is like the combined of the eternal associate and the Pradyumna of Chaturvyuh and Kamdev. Sometimes it will be very difficult for us to imagine that how is it possible that two or three people or sometimes four also, they come in within one body only. So you can understand this by the railway reservation system. In our railway reservation system, we have a policy of RAC, reservation against cancellation. India is a big country and many people who book tickets, they may not get seat also. So government has made this facility of RAC, that one berth is allotted to two people. Two people are sitting on the same berth. Something similar happens in the same body, many personalities are coming together. So this Pradyumna, the eternal associate of Lord, and also is the Anang, the Kamdev, the Cupid person, he comes in the form of this Pradyumna. Now text 22 mentions about the marriage of Pradyumna. Pradyumna, as you know, was born to Krishna and Rukmini. So he has already married Mayavati. Now this is the second marriage of Pradyumna that is being discussed here. So text 22. Shri Shuka Uvacha Vrita Swayamvare Sakshat अनंगो अंगयुतस्तया राज्ञा समेतान निर्जित्य जहारैकरथो युधि. श्री सुखदेव गोस्वामी सेड एट हर स्वयंवर सेरेमनी रुक्मवती हरसेल्फ चोस प्रद्युम्न हु वॉज री एम्बॉडीमेंट ऑफ क्यूपिड. देन ऑल्दो ही फॉट अलोन ऑन अ सिंगल चैरियट, Pradyumna defeated the assembled kings in battle and took her away. So all of us know that Krishna kidnapped Rukmini, and Rukmi, who was the brother of Rukmini, he was very envious of Krishna. When Krishna kidnapped Rukmini, then Rukmi took a vow that unless I defeat this Krishna and bring back my sister, I will not enter into Kundin fold. So the fool as he was, he followed Rukmi, he followed Krishna, and Krishna very easily defeated him and later gave him a peculiar haircut also. So distressed with that, he could not return to Kundinpur, and he made his kingdom there only. That place was called Bhojkat. So he stayed at that place only. Later Rukmi came to know that his daughter Rukmavati was attracted to Pradyumna, the son of Krishna. So although Rukmi was very envious of Krishna, he did not want to marry his daughter to Pradyumna, the son of Krishna. But what to do? The daughter was very adamant. So he agreed for the proposal. But he had to convince his friends and other kings who were envious of Krishna too. If they come to know that Rukmi is going to give his daughter to son of Krishna, his enemy, then they will not agree to this proposal. So he had to convince all of them. So he arranged for a Swayamvar ceremony. So Swayamvar, the name itself suggests Swayamvara, self-choice. So there are some very qualified girls who were given an opportunity to choose their own husbands, because many people wanted to marry them because of their qualities. So this Swayamvar ceremony was arranged especially among the warrior class, where the girl was given an opportunity to choose her husband. So Rukmavati was also very qualified, and she was also given this opportunity. But actually the main reason behind this Swayamvar was to convince, Rukmi wanted to convince his Krishna envious friends that what to do. I don't want to marry my daughter to Krishna's son, but what to do? This girl is very adamant. She won't follow my orders. So a person may stick to his desires, but when it comes to his children, he succumbs before his children. Many times it is seen that devotees start to practice Krishna consciousness, and in some devotees they have a background of like non-veg. So when they come to Krishna consciousness movement, they say, no, I will not eat non-veg. So there is a lot of opposition from the family in the beginning, but eventually the parents agree that okay, it's not something bad that my son is doing, so fine. So they agree to this proposal. Similarly, here Rukmi had to agree to Rukmavati about marrying Pradyumna. So he arranged this Swayamvar to convince the other Krishna envious friend that actually I don't want to marry my daughter. This is my daughter is only very adamant to marry Pradyumna. So when the Swayamvar happened, Rukmavati chose Pradyumna. Then what happened after that? Ragyan Sametan Nirjitya. So after that, all the other kings who had come to marry Rukmavati, they became envious of Pradyumna. So they made one party, and together they attacked Pradyumna. And Pradyumna single-handedly, Jahar Ek Ratho Yudhi, on a single chariot, he defeated all of those kings. So he proved his valiance and how he was qualified to marry Rukmavati. It is mentioned by the Acharyas that actually Rukmi was very affectionate to Pradyumna also, because he was his nephew. So he was very affectionate to Pradyumna. And after marriage, Pradyumna stayed quite for a long time in Bhojkat only. Somewhere it is mentioned that after marriage, he returned back to Dwarka and came back. And after that, he stayed for a long time in Bhojkat. And this Anirudh was born in Bhojkat only. He was not born in Dwarka. So such was the family ties. Then what is the reason that Pradyumna was married to Rukmavati by Rukmi, although he did not want? This is mentioned in the next shloka. यद्यपि अनुस्मरण वैरम रुक्मी कृष्णावमानितः व्यतरत भागिनेयाय सुताम कुर्वन् स्वसुप्रियम्। यद्यपि अनुस्मरण वैरम रुक्मी कृष्णावमानिता, रुक्मी वाज इंसल्टेड बाय कृष्णा, कृष्ण अवमानितः। यद्यपि अनुस्मरण वैरम, एंड ही रिमेंबर्ड दैट एनिमिटी फॉर अ लॉन्ग टाइम, बट स्टिल कुर्वन स्वसु प्रियम, इन ऑर्डर टू डू गुड फॉर हर सिस्टर, इन ऑर्डर टू प्लीज हर सिस्टर, ही मैरिड हर डॉटर सुताम भागिनेयाय व्यतरत। ही मैरिड हिज डॉटर टू हिज नेफ्यू भागिनेयाय। भागिनेय रेफर्स टू द नेफ्यू, भगिनी मीन्स सिस्टर, भागिनेय मीन्स द सन ऑफ सिस्टर, सो भागिनेय रेफर्स टू द नेफ्यू। सो ही गेव हिज डॉटर इन मैरिज टू Bhagine Pradyumna. Now this is a secondary reason to please her sister. The main reason is because Rukmati wanted to marry Pradyumna. But this is the secondary reason in order to please his sister. The answer purport is there. The answer to King's Parikshit's question is given here. Ultimately, Rukmi approved his daughter's marriage to Pradyumna in order to please his sister Rukmini. Now it is also mentioned that Krishna had one daughter from each of his 16,108 wives. Now somebody may ask that why only 10 sons only and only one daughter only. So as I mentioned, it is Bhagavati Srishti. It is not under the control of some material energy. So Krishna creates on his own will. It is not that many times it is seen in Indian family, people want a son. And then comes the daughter. Then next time they try again, they get a daughter. Like that time they try in line and 4 or 5 daughter comes, and then after that one son comes. So it is not something like that. It is Bhagavati Srishti. Krishna creates on his own will. Some people say that Krishna is lusty. So, but it's not like that. It's mentioned in Bhagavatam. Prodama bhava pishuna malaval guhasa mridavaloka nihato madanopiyasam sammuhya chapamajahat pramadottamasta yasendriyam vimathitum guhakarna shekuhu. That all these queens of Dwarka, they were very expert in the feminine expression. They were having very beautiful and pure smiles, and their side bashful sidelong glances, it attracted even Cupid, and Cupid had to drop his bow in frustration. But these queens of Dwarka, with all their feminine gestures, could not attract the senses of the Lord. So whenever there is love, Krishna is attracted. But whenever there is desire to fulfill one's own sense gratification, then Krishna is not attracted. So whenever the queens of Dwarka were in service mood, then Krishna was attracted to them. But when they wanted to attract Krishna by their feminine gesture, Krishna was not attracted. This goes to show that Krishna is not lusty. And the creation, the sons and daughters which he produced, was by his own, by yoga maya potency. So he produced one daughter from each of those 16,108 queens. And their marriage is mentioned in just one verse. So the eldest among them, the daughter of Rukmini, is Charumati. Her marriage is mentioned. Rukminyastanayam Rajan Kritavarma Sutobali Upeme Vishalakshim Kanyam Charumatim Kila. O King Bali, the son of Kritavarma married Rukmi's young daughter, large-eyed Charumati. So the eldest daughter of Krishna was from Rukmini. Her name was Charumati. Krishna married his daughter Charumati to Kritavarma, to the son of Kritavarma, Kritavarma Suto Bali, whose name was Bali. So it is mentioned about the beauty of Charumati, that she is Vishalakshim. She is having very large eyes. So large eyes is considered to be a symbol of beauty. And she was having Vishalakshi, she was having large eyes. So her eyes were very beautiful. It's not that only the eyes were beautiful, the entire form was very, very beautiful. This is the way of saying that beauty of one of the body organ is described to mention that the entire body was very beautiful. So she was very beautiful. And as the name suggests, Charumati, she was decorated with wonderful divine qualities also. And she was married to Kritavarma Suto Bali. It is mentioned that this Charumati looked somewhat similar to Krishna. Her form was somewhat, her beauty was somewhat similar to Krishna. So she was very fortunate. It is very prevalent notion in the society that if a girl has a face cut similar to that of his father, or a son has a face cut similar to that of the mother, then he is considered very fortunate. So this Charumati was looking similar to Krishna, and that is why according to the worldly notion she is considered very fortunate. So purport is also there. Shridhar Swami explains that each of the Lord's queens had one daughter, and that this mention of Charumati's marriage is an indirect reference to the marriages of all princes. So indirectly Sukhdeva Goswami is mentioning the marriage of all the daughters by this one shloka. Now this shloka which we read just now, text 25. दौहित्राय अनुरुद्धाय पौत्रीं रुक्म्या ददाधरे रोचनां बद्धवैरोपि स्वसुः प्रेचिकीर्षया जानन धर्मं तद्यौनं स्नेहपाशानुबंधनम्. दैट रुक्मी गेव हिस ग्रैंड डॉटर, हर नेम वॉज रोचना, टू हिस दौहित्र, मीन्स टू हिस टू द सन ऑफ हिस डॉटर. दैट इज कॉल्ड इन हिंदी से नाती, इट इज इन संस्कृत इज कॉल्ड एज दौहित्र, टू द डॉटर्स सन. His name was Aniruddha. So Aniruddha is the son of Pradyumna and Rukmavati. And he was married to the granddaughter of Rukmi. Her name was Rochana. Baddha Vairaha Pi. Although Rukmi was very envious of Krishna, but still he married. Why? Swasuhu prechikirshya, in order to please his sister Rukmini. Jana na dharmam tad yavanam sneha pashanubandhanam. He knew that this yavana, this marriage relationship is adharma. Actually, if we see the culture that is prevalent, especially in the northern India, people don't marry the daughter of one's maternal uncle, mama. It is mainly prevalent in northern India. Although in some places in India, like if you go to Andhra Pradesh or Telangana, Odisha or Maharashtra, such marriages are frequent, marrying the daughter of one's maternal uncle. But it is mentioned in some places in scriptures also that such marriages can be done if the gotra is different. But this is not a social custom, especially in North India. So from the social point of view, it was considered irreligious. So he said, Janan adharman tadyonam. Although he knew that this marriage is irreligious, but he still did that. Why? Swasuh prichikirshaya, to please his sister Rukmini. In purport, it is mentioned that Sridhar Swami says that one should not have family ties with one's enemies, nor should feed one enemy and go to eat in some enemy's house. We see that Krishna, when he went as a peace messenger to Hastinapur from the side of Pandavas, that time he put forward the proposal that Pandavas should be given the entire kingdom, because the kingdom rightly belongs to them. If you are not able to give the entire kingdom, at least give half the kingdom. If that also you are not ready to give, at least give 5 villages. They are Kshatriyas, they need to rule. But Duryodhan said, what to say of 5 villages? I cannot give that piece of land which comes under the tip of needle. So he refused the proposal of Krishna. So Krishna, and instead he tried to bind Krishna. Then Krishna exhibited his Virat Roop. And after that, when Krishna was about to go, in order to pacify Krishna, Duryodhan has arranged some big feast in the house of Dushasan. But Krishna did not took that feast, and rather he went to the house of Vidur and ate some shak, and some people say that banana peels he ate. So whenever there is love, Krishna Krishna takes anything whatever is offered by the devotees. But if there is no love, if there is any enmity, then no matter what is presented, even chappan bhog is presented, Krishna does not accept it. So this is mentioned in the purport. And another thing is mentioned, there is a prohibition, aswargyam lokavidvishtam dharmam api acharet natu. One should not execute the religious injunction if they will obstruct one's journey to heaven, or if they are odious to the human society. So although there are some prevalent social notions, but if they are obstruction to one's spiritual life, one should not follow that. It is mentioned here. So it was adharm, still he married his daughter to his granddaughter to Aniruddha. Later on it is mentioned that Krishna is not envious to anyone. Although Rukmi thought that Krishna is envious, Krishna is my enemy, but Krishna never thinks anybody to be his enemy. Krishna is Suhridam Sarvabhutanam. He is the ever-well-wishing friend of anyone and everyone. In English we have this word friend. But in Hindi or Sanskrit, there are different words for this friend. There is a word called Mitra. Mitra means official friendship. Then there is Bandhu. Bandhu means friendship within a home. And then there is a word like Sakha, people who eat together, means intimate relationship, intimate friendship. And then there is Suhrid. Suhrid means akaran hitaishi, benevolent without a cause. One who helps or one who does good without any cause. He is called Suhrid. Just like we see in the society, there is a relationship between mother and the child. Now child is helpless, he cannot do anything for the mother or the father. But still parents take care of the child without any return. This is called benevolence without any return. So this is the exact meaning of Suhrid. We see we may have so many friends in this world. Right from our childhood we may have so many friends. But the question is, how many of those friends we remember now? At best, we forget these friends. In the worst case, many times we pick up worst quarrel with our best friends. Correct, right? So the friendship in this world is like, you scratch my back, I will scratch yours. So long I need you, there is a relationship of friendship. But once there is no need, or the other party is in need, and we need the help of our friends, then the friends go away. Suddenly they become busy in their own worldly affairs. Suddenly they stop visiting us. So this is the nature of the friendship of this world. But Krishna is not a friend like this. He is Suhridam Sarva Bhutanam. He is the ever-well-wishing friend of all the living entities. Without any cause, he is benevolent to all the living entities. Only the Supreme Lord or the pure devotees of the Lord can be Suhrid, well-wishing friend of all the living entities. Prabhupada, whenever he used to write the letters to his disciples, he used to write, "Your ever-well-wisher, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami." He used to sign off like this, "Your ever-well-wisher." So Krishna is the real friend. He never gives up with the living entities. No matter what the living entity does, he is always there with the living entity. He is there in the Paramatma feature. No matter in what species of life the living entity goes, still he is there with that living entity. This goes to show that how much the Krishna, he loves the living entity. We can just understand with this. Imagine one fine day, where we ask our very loving friend that I am going to gutter. Will you come to me? Come with me? Nobody would want to come to gutter. But even when the living entity becomes the worm in the stool, Krishna comes with him in the form of Paramatma. He agrees to stay with him. Although he is not affected, he is totally spiritual, but still he agrees to come. This is the real friendship. Even when the other party is not wanting to have relationship, still if one wants to serve, so that is the real friendship. In this world we see that if in a relationship a person ditches another person frequently or he speaks lies too often, then that relationship is not going to last for a long time. But Krishna is such a friend that he is always there with the living entity. Even there are people who say, "I don't believe in God, I hate God," but still Krishna is there within their heart as Paramatma. He is supplying them with all the necessities of life. This is the real friendship. So he is called Suhridam Sarva Bhutanam. He is Suhrid because he manifests this entire world. This manifestation of the world is a mercy of the Supreme Lord. It is not that Krishna wants to do something in this material world, so he creates this material world. No. He creates this material world to give the facility to the living entity to get frustrated in their attempts to enjoy separate from Krishna. Living entity wants to enjoy separate from Krishna. So Krishna creates a facility for him that, okay, try to enjoy and then get frustrated and then come back to me. So this is an attempt, this is a facility that is given by the Lord. Srila Prabhupada explains by the example of toy kitchen. That sometimes the children are very adamant and they say, "No, I will cook, I will cook, I will cook. Today I want to cook my own food." But the mother explains that, "No, my dear child, it will be difficult for you to cook. I will cook. Today we are cooking such a nice feast. We are cooking puri, halwa, paneer, so many things we are cooking. Just wait for some time and there will be a big feast and then we will enjoy." But the child is adamant. He starts rolling on the ground, knocking the ground. "No, no, I will cook, I will cook, I will cook. Without you, I will cook," like that. Then mother understands what a headache, and then she has to supply the toy kitchen. So in that toy kitchen, there is plastic kadhai, plastic bhagona, and plastic, all the utensils, they are made up of plastic. Plastic stove is there, plastic cylinder is there, and then wax vegetables are there, and he's busy cutting his vegetables for 3 hours with his plastic knife. But after 3 hours, he feels hungry. And then he looks and here and there, where is mother? He cannot eat the food which he has cooked on his own. Then he runs towards mother, and mother is ready with a big feast. Similarly, we also, from time memorial, from so many births, are trying to cook out the happiness from the ingredients that have been supplied to us in this material world. But then we get frustrated. This is the nature of this material world, and Krishna has designed it in such a way that the living entity gets frustrated. Prahlad Maharaj says, "Kutra shisha shruti shukha mrigatrishni rupa vedam kale varamashesh rojam miroha nirvidyate natu jano yadpiti vidvan कामानलम मधुलवै शमयन्दुरापै कुत्र शिशा श्रुति सुखा मृगतृष्ण रूपा. द सेंस प्लेजर्स ऑफ दिस वर्ल्ड दे आर श्रुति सुखा, दे गिव प्लेजर ओनली इन हियरिंग, दे आर नॉट एक्चुअली प्लेजरफुल, द ओनली हियरिंग दे गिव प्लेजर. एंड मृगतृष्ण रूपा, दे आर लाइक मृगतृष्णा, दे आर लाइक मिराज. समटाइम्स इन द डेजर्ट वी सी द एनिमल, दे सी दैट एट लॉन्ग डिस्टेंस देर इज वाटर एंड दे गो टू दैट प्लेस टू फाइंड आउट देर इज नो वाटर. बट देन अगेन दे सी फ्रॉम एट अ लॉन्ग डिस्टेंस देर इज वाटर, अगेन टू दे रन टू दैट प्लेस. सिमिलर लाइक दिस दे गो ऑन रनिंग रनिंग एंड अल्टीमेटली देयर लाइफ कम्स टू एंड. Similarly, people in this world, they find that no, we are living in village, there will be pleasure in cities. So they run towards the cities. From cities, they want to run towards bigger cities, Bombay, Delhi. From bigger cities, they want to run towards USA. From USA, they want to go to moon. But there is no happiness. This is Mrigatrishni Rupa. Kvedam Kalevaram Ashesh Rujam Viroha. And you want to enjoy with this body gives birth to so many diseases. Ashesh Rujam Viroha. But person knows this, he hears this in the Bhagavatam class, he reads this, he hears Prabhupada class, and he speaks also in Bhagavatam, whenever there is Bhagavatam class. But nirvidyate natujano yadapita vidvan, he develops no detachment from this sense pleasure. He is trying to satisfy this fire of the material desires by the honey of the sense gratification. If you put honey in fire, will the fire stop? No, it will emerge more furiously. Similarly, a living entity is trying to satisfy the kama, the lust of his heart, with the sense objects of this world. Kama lalam madhulava ishamayan durapai. Durapai, they are found with great difficulty. So this is the nature of this material world. Krishna has made this material world, he has organized this material world in such a way that the living entity gets frustrated. So this is his mercy towards the living entity. Not only he creates the material world, he himself comes to this material world to exhibit his pastimes. Okay, you are rotting in this material world, see what is the spiritual world. You can come back to the spiritual world and have eternal pastimes with me. So when Krishna comes to this material world, one of the reasons is to advertise. To advertise what kind of pastimes are going on in the spiritual world. So that people hear that, they witness those pastimes when Krishna is actually there. And when Krishna wounds up his pastime, then sages like Vyasadeva, they put all those pastimes into literature like Srimad Bhagavatam. And after that, devotees read, relish, hear, remember these pastimes and get away from this material world. Bhaveshmin klishyamana naam. Avidya kam karma bhi, shravan, smaran, arahani, karishyanti kechana. The living beings, they are tormented by the material desires. Kam, karma bhi, they are bound up in the fruitive activities. And this is all because of avidya, ignorance. That I am this body and everything that is related to this body is mine. But the living entity, when he hears the pastimes of Krishna, he relishes these pastimes of Krishna, he speaks them, then automatically is avidya, kam and karma. The ignorance, the desires that are born out of ignorance, and the fruitive material activities which it is a result of those desires, all of them get destroyed. This is the reason why Krishna comes to this material world, to exhibit his pastimes. Jivera karane ashya prapanche lila koile suvistar, Bhaktivinoda Thakur says. That for the living entity, jivera karane, Krishna comes to this material world. Otherwise, Krishna has no need to come to this material world. It is not that he came to this material world because he found the spiritual world boring. He wanted a change. It's not like that. Or he came to taste something of this material world. No. Krishna comes for the living entity. So this is the mercy of Krishna, that he comes to this material world. Even to those people who are envious of Krishna, Krishna kills them and sends them to his own abode. That is why one of the names of Krishna is Hatari Gatidayaka. He kills the living entity who are envious to him and sends them back to his own abode. Paramahansa Radha Govind Maharaj, he says that, do you find a such person who beats up another person and says him that my flat is empty, you can go and rest there. But Krishna is like that. He kills the living entity, the demons, and sends back them to his own abode. That is why he is called as Atari Gatidayaka. All the people who are killed in the battlefield of Kurukshetra, at least they got Sayuja Mukti, which great gyanis even don't get after great attempts. Tathai vachanye narlokavira ya ahave krishna mukhar avindam netre pibanto nayanabhiramam parthastraputa padamapurasya. There are many people who had to fight on the side of Duryodhan because they had some obligation to Hastinapur kingdom, although they didn't want to fight. Like Bhishma Pitama was there, Dronacharya was there, Shalya was there. These people, they were very friendly to the Pandavas, but they had to fight on the opposite party. But opposite party they had to fight, they had an advantage. They used to drink the beauty of Krishna through their eyes. Tathai vichanye narlokavira netre pibanto nayanabhiramam. They used to drink the beauty of Krishna through their eyes. It is not said that they were seeing Krishna. They used to drink the beauty of Krishna through their eyes. The beauty of Krishna is the festival for the eyes, Nayanabhiramam. And in the midst of all this, suddenly they used to get an arrow from Partha, and immediately they used to go back home, back to Godhead. So these are people who are not envious of Krishna, but there were certain people who were envious of Krishna. So these people, there are such an arrangement that whenever they died, they got the darshan of the Lord sitting on the back of Garuna and holding his chakra. Anshe sunabha yuduma patantam. You are sitting on the back of Garuna and getting the darshan of Krishna holding a disc weapon, chakra in his hand. So such was the arrangement in the Kurukshetra battle. So Krishna never hates anyone. It is not in his nature only. Just like if sun god wants to meet the night, then it's very difficult for him. If Lakshmi Devi wants to become poor, then it is not possible for her. Similarly, if Krishna wants he should hate any living entity, it is not at all possible for him. It is not in his nature only. By nature, he is Sachidananda. Anybody who comes in contact with him becomes happy, no matter with what attitude he comes. So after that, in the purport, it is mentioned that there are different gradations of dharma, but the ultimate is Bhagavad Dharma. So there are two types of dharma, Varnashram Dharma and Bhagavad Dharma. The Varnashram Dharma is to support the Bhagavad Dharma. Whatever rules and regulations are mentioned in the scripture is that, the purpose is that Smartavyam Satitam Vishnu Vismartavyam Najaduchi Sarve Vidhi Nishedamsha Etayorev Kinkaraha. All the rules and regulations, do's and don'ts in the scriptures, they are for what? Smartavyam Satitam Vishnu Vismartavyam Najaduchi. Always remember Krishna and never forget Krishna. This is the main purpose. So if the Varnashram Dharma is becoming an impeding our Krishna consciousness life, then that dharma can be left. So there are gradations in the dharma. For example, there is a dharma that one should speak truth. But imagine we are standing on the street and there is a tea cut, and suddenly a cow comes running with at full speed and goes in one direction. After 5 minutes, one person with a big saw axe in his hands comes behind, and he's a butcher, and he's asking, "Where is the cow gone? Where is the cow gone?" Now it is the dharma to speak the truth, but in this case, if we speak truth, then it will be adharma. So dharma in this place is to speak lie and save the cow. If he has gone in this direction, say he has gone in this direction. So this is the dharma. So dharma also has various gradations. It is to speak truth is a dharma, but Yudhishthir Maharaj, for him dharma was to speak lie. When Krishna asked him to speak lie that Ashwatthama is dead. Although he spoke lie, but after that he said, Narova Kunjaro. Whether man Ashwatthama has died or the elephant Ashwatthama has died, that I don't know. Silently he has said. But he spoke the lie. So this is Sarva Dharman Parityajya. Bhagavad Dharma, for Bhagavad Dharma, the temporary dharma, the Varnashram Dharma can be given up. And then it is mentioned here that some people say that if the practice of Krishna consciousness is opposing to the customs in the Western countries, then those ceremonies or the activities should not be done. So I was reading the 10th canto, and there the first chapter, the birth of Krishna. Second chapter, birth of Krishna has been described. So very nice shlokas there. Sa devaki sarva jagan nivasa nivasa bhuta nitaram nareje भोजेन्द्र गेहे अग्निशिखे वरुद्धा सरस्वती ज्ञान खले यथास्ति. सो देयर इट इज मेंशनड सा देवकी सर्व जगन निवासा निवास भूता. सो दैट देवकी, दैट वंडरफुल, दैट मैग्निफिशेंट देवकी हु वाज शाइनिंग लाइक एनीथिंग व्हेन कृष्णा एंटर्ड विद इन हर, शी सर्व जगन निवास निवास भूता. लॉर्ड इज कॉल्ड एज सर्व जगन निवास. ऑल द यूनिवर्सेस दे रेस्ट विद इन द पोर्स ऑफ Mahavishnu, who is the plenary expansion of Krishna. So is Sarva Jagan Nivas, that Devaki became the Jagan Nivas Nivas Bhuta, means she became the residence of that Lord who holds all the universe within his skin pores. This is an astonishment. Bilwa Mangal Thakur in Krishnanamrita, he mentions one shlok. He said, Yatro Maranda Paripurti Vidhava Daksha Varaha Janmani Babhuva Ami Samudra तम नामनाथम अरविंद दृशम यशोदा पाणी द्वयांतर जलय स्नपयाम भूवा. दैट वेन वन ऑफ द फॉर्म ऑफ कृष्णा इज वराहदेव. वेन लॉर्ड वराहदेव अपियर्ड, हिज वन स्किन पोर वॉज सच ह्यूज that if you take water from all the ocean and put in that one skin pore, still it will not overflow. Such was the size of Varahadev. In the picture, we see very beautiful Varahadev with golden tusk, with helmet and golden gada. But this was the size of Varahadev. But when the same Varahadev appears in the form of Krishna, the lotus-eyed Krishna, then Mother Yashoda takes water in her cupped hand and bathes Krishna. So that Lord, who is the sustainer of all the universes, the Devaki became the residence of that Lord. Sarv Jagat Nivas Nivas Bhuta Nitram Nareje. But she was not shining that much. Means people were not able to get benefit from her that much. Why? Because Bhojendra Gehegni Shikhevarudha. She was captured within the prison house of Kamsa. And here Devaki is compared to Agni Shikha. Agni Shikha means fire. She is compared to fire. That actually it appears that Devaki, within Devaki's womb is Krishna. And Kamsa has captured Devaki within the prison. So it appears that Kamsa has captured Krishna within his prison. But she is like fire. Just like in a house, if you see that sometimes the stove turns over and the curtain catches fire. So if we see at this stage, the situation will be that fire is within the house. But after 3 hours, the situation will be the house is on fire. So Sukhdev Goswami is mentioning that it appears that that Kamsa has captured Krishna. But actually Krishna is just like fire. He will burn Bhojendra Gehe and he will burn Bhojendra also. He burned Kamsa and his house also. So Acharyas explain, or like this Krishna consciousness movement is just like Krishna only. Prabhupada says Krishna consciousness movement is an expansion of Krishna. And Krishna appears in the Krishna consciousness movement to benefit the living entities. But Kamsa like leaders, they have captured Krishna. They don't want to propagate the message of Krishna. Srimad Bhagavatam, Bhagavad Gita. But don't worry, Agni Shikheva Ruddha. Krishna is like Agni. Whenever initially one may be able to capture him for some time, but after some time, the house will be on fire. Those leaders who are not allowing the Krishna consciousness movement to propagate, they will burn, they will be destroyed. Here it is mentioned, Rukmi could not impede the performance of Lord Krishna's pure pastimes. You see, practically, we'll end in 2-3 minutes, practically all over the world where preaching has happened, there was a great resistance from the leaders. They didn't want this message to propagate. Prabhupada tried so hard to propagate this mission. Initially he wrote to Gandhiji, he wrote to Jawaharlal Nehru, he even met Indira Gandhi. He told to Gandhiji, wrote to Gandhiji that actually enough of politics now, you are a big man, people follow you, now leave politics and take to Krishna consciousness. Spread this message of Bhagavad Gita. If you read Bhagavad Gita, then all the people will follow you. He told to Jawaharlal Nehru that don't speak that these temples, these factories are temples, take to Krishna consciousness. And when he met to Indira Gandhi, he has a whole list of things to do. That how all the MPs should be Brahman initiated devotees, the parliament session should begin with kirtans. So actually this knowledge has been there in India for a long time, but it was impeded, it was restricted by the Kamsa-like leaders. It was not allowed to spread. But today, by the mercy of Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, by the hard work done by Srila Prabhupada, now it is being spread all over the world. So our knowledge has its relevance so long it is spread. If it is not spread, then it will become obsolete. It becomes dried up. People say it has no practical relevance. But now we see it is being spread all over the world. In Russia also we see, when the KGB regime was there, devotees faced so many obstacles to spread this movement. The first devotee, he had to undergo so many turmoils. Ultimately, he was packed. He was sacked up in the mental asylum in Siberia. In our preaching also, we see that practically all over India, wherever college preaching is happening, it is happening in banned status. Very few places we have the allowance from the authorities that you come and preach. But Bhojendra Gehegni Shikheva Ruddha. Krishna is like that knowledge who is capped. Bhojendra Gehe Shikha Agni Viruddha Saraswati Gyan Khale Yathasati. Very soon he will spread all over the world. Hare Krishna. La Prabhupada Ki Jai. Samved Gaur Bhaktivinoda Ki Jai. Nitai Gaur Premanande Hari. Hare Krishna.